Hey guys, I'm nickmeistersa and welcome to a brand new Let's Play adventure. With me today is my friend circlmastr. Say hello.
I am sick and tired of you, nickmeistersa. You're a loose cannon. You're off the case. Turn your badge off, and gun.
Off which case?
The case you were on before. I'm busting you down to beat cop.
Okay. So no more saving cats out of trees or taking out the garbage.
Nope, you're the shit catcher now. You're gonna wish
Great.
You were saving cats from trees.
Great, that sounds fantastic. So here we are. L.A. Noire came out in 2011. Got kind of mixed responses. They call them tutorial cases, but there's a lot of important story. That's why I left them in here.
Yeah, you better leave them in there. You need the training.
A city on the verge of greatness. A new type of city, based not on the man, but on the automobile. The car. The symbol of freedom and vitality.
I wonder
Every
if that guy's important.
Every man can own his own home, and have room to breathe, and not be overlooked by his neighbors. A city where a man's home is his castle. A quarter acre of the dream made possible by victory.
I wonder if that guy's important.
I don't know, yeah, I mean...
The city of dreams, where Hollywood.
Oh my god, they cut off that horse's legs.
And it seems to be taking it like a champ.
Yeah, well, you know, they pump him up with a lot of drugs, I think. So, he's probably not feeling it. You're from California. You ever been to Hollywood?
I have.
What'd you think about it?
Hollywood is about 5% of made up of glamour and glitz and movie shit, and 95% slum.
Really, that's not all that surprising.
20th century city that will become a model.
That's pretty much true of all of Los Angeles, really. Los Angeles County, I should say.
Uh-huh.
Which is what most people think of when they say Los Angeles.
That will stretch as far as the. I think LA seems kind of scary to me. Your police are out of control, as we'll soon see. Let's call it a segue.
In the Marine Corps, you deal with the chain of command. Mistakes get made, but you deal with them. You know what you're fighting for, and that you're on the same team. But dealing with corruption is like chasing
shadows. I want that shadow on my desk by Friday.
You never know whether the guy you're talking to is on the pad, or whether it's your partner,
okay.
Even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGPL calling car, 14 Adam. 14 Adam, come in.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective, an ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street. 16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
Roger, 14 Adam en route.
How did an ambulance shoot somebody?
Here we go again. They don't request uniforms for evidence search unless there's
we'll
some kind of catch.
Crack that
Ever
case
the optimist. From the
soon.
Beam of sunshine himself.
Yeah, you'll probably stumble half-assed backwards into it. Not even your full ass. You're going to half-ass stumbling backwards into it.
Of course. That's how this game is played. You just run in the general direction of the clues and click until something happens.
Floyd Rose, homicide. You might back up?
Yes, sir. Phelps and Dunn, Wilshire Division.
We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue. Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece. I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
You want us to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a lowlife. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
And if we recover the weapon?
Bag it and return it to technical services.
You hurry
it
up, Floyd. We've got places to be.
Happy hunting.
That Floyd Rose, he is a peach.
This is a fist hump. Just going through the motions.
You're probably right. Let's just get it over and done.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to the back wall.
If you still don't, you're already screwing up.
Come find me, and we'll talk it out. I was thinking about just giving up this
whole
thing.
What are you doing, Cole? You've gone too far.
Hey, you still have a job to do.
Just awful.
Don't make me bust you down to meter maid.
You're not gonna be like this other guy over here, this fist humping guy, are you?
No, he knows what I'm talking about. I busted him down, and he knows it. Why do you think he talks about fist humping?
I don't want you to elaborate on that, please. Let's just get back to
To what? Do you wandering around not searching the alleyway?
No, the opposite. Searching the alleyway. Okay. Any clues over there? So, Floyd Rose wants us to look for a gat.
It's not my job to pick through other people's trash.
This guy behind us is going to keep complaining.
Probably because you're doing a slow-ass job of it.
Yeah, well, not all of us have places to be.
What have you got, Phelps? Anything?
Seriously, he talks way too much. So, a big part of this game is picking stuff up and looking at it. Oh, the shrink says something.
I tell you, I'm jinxed. I always get landed with this crap.
You reading on the job, you asshole?
If anything, to get away from that guy's constant complaining.
Dr. Fontaine, could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, Doc. Psychiatry seems...
You can tell he's a southern gentleman because he's got a white suit.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work.
Really, the accent wasn't the clue there?
Is the last great...
It's Foghorn Leghorn.
No wonder you were such a bad cop.
Sheldon. I say, boy. It's got to be something about your super ego.
They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war. That's what I wanted to talk to
bad
you about.
Bad cop and a Freudian.
Battle fatigue.
You're just two wrongs making a right.
Can it be helped?
I would say yes.
I don't know. You know what they say about...
Trauma.
No, negative times negative equals positive, something like that. There's got to be something there. Haven't quite worked it out yet. Haven't looked at all the angles, but I'm sure I'll come up with something.
In the right hands. I'm sure you'll come up with a pile of shit.
Yeah, I'll leave a big steaming pile on your desk by Friday, I swear it.
A good friend of mine. So far away. It's like he's wandering.
This is L.A., I don't want no Cleveland steamer.
If you treat like this, I'm just gonna quit.
I'd like to see you quit. I'd like to see you have the balls to walk into my office and directly speak to me.
Come and work at one of them in your spare time. With what little spare time a medical student has. Is that a deal?
All right, so...
I can't thank you enough.
This shit here is why I left in the boring tutorial cases. Because, it really does a good job at setting the story, especially after you finish it, I guess. I don't know. There you go.
You have no idea the depth of my disappointment.
We're never gonna find it, it's a waste of time.
That guy's got a creepy walk. Alright. Alright, this is our first clue. Someone likes beer, apparently.
Doesn't look like anything.
Well, I disagree. I think it looks like a beer bottle. Okay. So, anyway, Floyd Rose wanted us to find a gun. It's gotta be around here somewhere. Over here is where I guess the guy got ended.
Got ended. That's some real professional grammar you got there.
Shooter, put him up against the wall.
I'm trying to be
hell of a way to
sensitive
go.
To the victim's plight.
Doesn't really matter how you go once you're gone.
Don't get all
of
deep
having
on Phelps.
A hole in his head.
Yeah, he's dead. You don't have to care about being politically correct toward him.
You know, being around all this death and carnage can make a guy, callous towards, you know, life and death and things like that. But I like to think that, you know, as a police officer, I maintain my empathy towards, Okay, so, here's the gun, a reflection of the gun.
Ralph.
On the roof.
Something on the rooftop.
Very clever detective
stuff.
How the
hell did you see that?
Reflection in the window. Looks like it might be our weapon. I'm gonna see if I can find a way up there.
I know the last time recorded this, you had like a problem with the logistics of how the reflection would work or something.
Yeah, once you get on the roof, it's obvious that there is no way in hell Cole could have seen that gun.
And see, that's why you're sitting at a desk instead of out in the streets actually doing the real work.
No, I can smell bullshit when I see it. This is obviously some bullshit falsified police report. He was screwing off. He and his partner were probably giving each other HJs on the roof and just happened to see the gun. And they couldn't write to me. We were giving each other HJs on the roof. They had to come up with some bullshit explanation for why they were up there.
You know, back then they used to call them fist humps, not HJs.
No, a fist hump is something completely different. And if you had the balls to come into my office when I call you and tell you what a fuck-up you are, you would know. You would know firsthand the difference between an HJ and a fist hump.
Yeah, firsthand.
Exactly.
Yeah, I think I'm going to have to sue you for sexual harassment or something, because,
This is fucking 1947. Right. So, there ain't no sexual harassment. Don't you bring your liberal bullshit, commie, hippie crap to me.
All right, Chief. All right. we got clues, we got people, blah, blah, blah. I mean, you'll be seeing a lot more of this stuff in later videos. Yeah. What am I doing here? I can't even remember. Oh, there's Floyd Rose. His name will pop up a little later in this video. Doesn't really come to anything, but it is interesting, because I kind of feel like this game has a lot of little bits and pieces that you miss if you weren't paying attention.
Could show some initiative, Ralph.
And it should be easy to come up pick out all the small
That's
details
shot,
talking over
it's
everything.
It's pretty fancy
so.
Gun.
You're welcome.
You know a local gun store?
Sure. There's a place a couple of blocks from here.
Okay. And I don't know if anyone ever really put their flashlight on their shirt like that back in the 1940s, but it lets us run around.
Are you sure about this?
Oh, well,
really
he's not doing that.
No harm in doing some digging.
Haven't you ever seen Silent Hill 3?
Such a little Boy Scout, Cole. You can't wait to get out of that.
Kind of try to stay away from those games.
You'd rather round up right, you're a giant puss.
Across the road.
I'd rather get through the day without having to put up my ass.
It'll be fine.
Maybe that's why you don't come in my office. You're afraid you'll enjoy a fist hump.
Unless it's manhunt. You better watch out. I'll kill you with a toothpick or something.
Yeah, right. That was your alternate personality.
That's right.
That got killed during the war when PTSD took over.
Well, you know, all the big stars have split personalities. Eminem's got Marshall Mathers and Slim Shady. I think Beyonce has an alternate ego. I have one too.
Yeah, except your alter ego is also a puss.
It's one that plays Manhunt and is one that takes a big shit in your desk when you're not looking. So look forward to that.
Like I said, they're both giant pussies.
So driving is really exciting in this game. It's really the best part.
Yeah, I'm really glad you showed off the fact that you don't have to actually drive anywhere.
Well, we'll be doing plenty of that as we go along. Yeah.
Instead, I'm stuck sitting here watching you fumble your way through red lights.
I'm a police officer. I don't have to respect the law.
You do have to run your siren, though.
I don't even respect myself, and I am the law, so why would I... You see, that's...
Yeah, you didn't think that one through, did you?
A great force in a great city. You see that? Get out of my fucking way.
Jesus!
I ain't Jesus, buddy.
You are going...
Excuse me?
Fast.
You don't tell me what to do.
Hey, stuff it. You're here to serve and protect. You're not here to give people
shit. I think I'm a better judge
shit.
Of how fast I'm going than this jackass.
I'm here to give people shit. If you think you can do my job, you got another thing coming.
All right, it's a gun shop here.
No shit. Did the gun sign tell you, or all the guns on display?
Officers Phelps and Dunn.
So, are there gun shops in Hollywood nowadays?
Smith & Wesson. Of course.
Model 27, registered Magnum.
I didn't realize they had gun shops in cities.
Nickel-plated with pearl grip.
Maybe that's just Boston.
Same gun used by General Patton.
You're not suggesting he's the owner?
No, I'm not.
You seem to know a lot about the weapon.
I ought to. I sold it.
Whoa,
you know this
hey.
Piece will stop a rhino.
Hey, be careful.
These babies are only available special
order. Hey, I'll take his here's poor trigger discipline over your poor you attitude, thinking skills, physical abilities, and investigation abilities any day. Oh, he is a fucking model gun. Officer compared
you see it
to
on
you.
There?
Let's try to find this gun. It's got a pearl grip or something. Blued steel, something like that. You know, the first time I played through this game, I would just tap on everything until the story progressed, but since I'm doing a Let's Play, I'm trying to, you know, do it the right way. There we go.
Yeah, there's one case I remember later on where you're given a list like this to look over, and I had no idea what was the right one, so I just ended up tapping every single one till it was right, and even after tapping the right one, I still didn't know why it was right.
Right. The guy's like, oh, yes, it seems that this thing, you know, I don't...
Do we call it in?
Let's see if he's at home.
I remember that thing.
Owning the gun doesn't...
The cases later on get really convoluted, especially since
a
lot of the evidence you collect doesn't really make any sense when you use them in the interrogations, but you'll see that more later on. And I'm using the siren now, so you happy or what?
It doesn't seem to improve your driving any.
Well, you know... One step at a time. Baby steps.
Now, that yeah, I'd say so baby hard, is a pretty good
description for
you. Just
because we're in uniform doesn't mean we can't use
Die.
Our initiative. I guess so. Seems
yeah,
a little too good
you.
To be true.
Way to go.
What?
Way to go.
That's a chain-link fence. It's supposed
if
to just fall away.
No, that's only when a real driver hits one.
And that's why they get caught.
Here I am looking at the map. Let's see. Oh, it's all the way fucking over there. All right. All right.
If only there was some way to get to your destination almost immediately by not driving the car.
Phelps Encyclopedia of Thin Air. Really
wait, you wish I didn't flap my arms? Or do you mean let my partner drive so I can just take a nap? You know, lay my head down. That was my favorite thing to do as a kid when I went on long... road trips with my family, I'd lay down my head and take a nap, and then it'd be like I was there almost instantaneously, so maybe that is a good idea. I'll just, you know, put my finger on the W key, lay down my head, and wake up in 20, 30 minutes or so, and I'll be there, maybe.
It's probably a better use of your time.
Sure, you know, catch on some Z's. Catch up while I'm asleep. Oh boy.
If only you'd catch up on your work.
Boom. Run, run! Ah!
Yeah, I think he's got the legitimate complaint there. You're acting like you did that on purpose to scare him, but really, you're just a shitty driver. And the city of Los Angeles is more dangerous for you being here.
Then I'm doing my job correctly. The less people that come to Hollywood, the safer it'll be, because I don't have to worry about policing people. That guy's got a truck full of dirt for some reason. It's kind of weird.
I don't know. Maybe he's a landscaper.
But loose dirt with not in bags or anything? That's kind of strange, isn't it?
You dig out a tree, you gotta fill the hole where the tree trunk went in.
Schroeder, apartment 2.
Alright, let's see this guy Schroeder, see what he's got to say for himself. They never put these guys on the ground floor for some reason. I don't understand why.
Probably because the ground floor is the most dangerous place to live in an apartment building.
But these guys are all criminals.
I'm Officer Cole Phelps.
What would they care about living in a dangerous place?
Wilshire Division. You're the owner of
they still don't want to be victimized by other criminals.
Pearl grips?
I might be. What, like the police? Are you a traitor, Chief?
To know that Scooter
no.
Was murdered tonight.
I'm saying, if somebody wants to break into an apartment building... They
you
bust in a ground floor window. They're not going to bring a ladder with them to bust into a third floor apartment window.
What the fuck is going on here? You're under arrest,
unless they're
Schroeder,
a teenager wanting to,
you're not taking me down for this.
Know. Okay. Here's a fist fight.
You ready, tough guy?
It's pretty easy. You just hold the space bar to block. And when they're not attacking you, you can attack them. And the best time to attack them is right after you block one of their punches. Okay.
Yeah, it seems like your punches don't do shit.
Well, your timing's gotta be perfect. Okay, so when that guy was dizzy, I should have grabbed him. There we go.
Oh, we got things to do.
Do you hear what my partner just said? That's ridiculous. He's like knocked the fuck out.
Yeah, because your partner probably could have taken him down in two shots.
He's lucky he caught me.
Except he was on his back, sleeping.
Keep an eye on him, Ralph. I'm gonna take a look around.
He was trying to pass the time.
How did he call you out for taking too long if he was asleep? Great observation skills right there, nickmeistr.
Hmm. Seems like there's a hole in my theory here, but, you know.
Kind of like the one in your head.
A bunch of names and numbers, whatever. Oh, Floyd Rose? That was the detective that we talked to in the beginning of the game.
List of names and a series of numbers. Floyd Rose's name is in this book.
Hmm. Very mysterious.
So we can come out of this all bright and shiny with a commendation. Or stick our schlongs in a
hornet's nest.
The
second one sounds pretty fun. Maybe we should
call
do
it
that.
In, partner.
Yeah, you would
Leave
enjoy
the
that.
Book where you found it.
It'll make it bigger, get all swollen.
Officer Phelps, that's 1247.
Saving our progress.
Yeah, what little progress you can be said to have made.
God, it's all foggy.
Well, duh, that's memory mist. That's how you know it's a flashback.
Huh.
When 3/4 of the screen is obscured by memory mist.
That's kind of like what the subway looks like. On my way to work sometimes. It's all foggy. No one can see where they're going.
You dumb fucking sons of bitches! Get in this line now before I lose
mad.
My temper!
Excuse me, Sergeant, but...
Excuse me!
Oh, I like this guy
you
a lot.
You say another word and I'll break your
I
fucking head and have you in the
brig. I think that's our title for the thread.
Some of us are here for...
I know why you're here, asswipe!
Excuse me? Fuck
I'm
you.
I'm having a bad day, bro.
Well, it would have been, except
Some
now you called it out.
To get on this bus.
Didn't ask for your help.
He didn't ask
no, that's
for your
that's
help.
What you're
Can you believe
to do?
This guy?
Call it out.
Who are you two? Abbott and Costello?
We're here for OCS, Sergeant.
So it's the three fucking stooges and you're here for OCS.
They're hilarious.
I love this Sergeant. I want to hire him.
The Japanese will do the world a favor and kill you quick. All three of you are on report. What are your fucking names?
Phelps.
Kelso.
Merrill.
What? I don't remember any of those.
Any other gentlemen for OCS? OCS is at Elliott. You take the Camp Elliott bus over there. This bus is for MCRD. This bus is for men who want to fight.
You can't call yourself out for being a pussy.
I didn't call myself out. I called them out.
Yeah, but one of them is you.
Secret. No. I'm not those guys.
Well, you picked the
I'm
right
a tough
place,
guy.
Cole.
No,
See,
you're not. We've established that you're not.
I'm out of control. On the edge. Loose cannon.
Solve cases. Right.
Badass cop with nothing to lose.
The force is like politics.
Yes, you're as bad a cop as you are an asshole.
Brown Why, thank you. Does that mean I'm a nice person?
No. That means you're a terrible person and a terrible cop. And you're no way tough or dangerous, Mr. I Can't Even Face a Silent Hill Game.
But you would agree that I am a loose cannon, right?
Yeah, I'm more like loose screw.
I mean, I screw's loose on the base of the cannon. And I'm out of control. Yeah, I mean, you can see that when I'm driving. I think this is the one where you get to shoot people with guns in the face.
So instead you decide to swerve around like an idiot.
You see how loose I am on the road?
You got a loose grip on reality there, nickmeistr.
I just knocked that guy's umbrella out of his hand with my car. That's some pretty good driving.
No, it's pretty awful.
But I didn't hit him, but I knocked the umbrella out of his hand. That's pretty impressive. This precision driving right there.
No, it's not. It's you swerving around like an idiot and getting too close to the sidewalk. You can't say what you did on accident was done on purpose to display talent.
I did it on purpose. And I wasn't
yeah,
forward.
Right. I'll believe that. Use the cover, as soon as you have the balls to say that to my face.
We don't know how many are in there.
Okay.
Take it slow.
As long as you pay for the plane ticket.
LAPD, put down
your
weapons.
Do I look like your fucking bankroll? I am your boss.
I'm offering you a chance.
You work for me. I don't work for you.
Stay down. So, you know, the bricks and things crumble away like styrofoam. And I remember back in 2006, a game called Stranglehold, it was like a shooter game, came out. And I was really excited about the whole crumbling rocks game engine. I thought it was really cool that the game could just do that stuff on the fly. Yeah, it looks like styrofoam. Huh. I think we killed them all.
That's it? We got them all? I think we got them, Cole.
Are you sure?
Should be all clear.
Maybe double taps just to make sure. Oh, damn it.
Lieutenant Hopkins says anytime you reach for the shotguns, you're either going to end up dead or wearing a citation. So I guess...
It's okay, Ralph. You didn't.
No,
well
you didn't.
That.
You're a fucking pussy.
Glad you have my back.
You should be, like, creaming in your pants right now at the fact that you killed someone.
Except that you didn't. You stole all his kills, you selfish bastard. Way to be a team player.
It's like a game of call.
That's why you're a loose cannon. You just pay no attention to what your partner, your co-workers, or the innocent citizens of Los Angeles are doing. All you care about is murdering people and driving like a shithead.
I'm trying to upgrade my shotgun to get prestige for that shit.
If I can make a name for myself in this war, my future. Thinking of taking on a company of the Emperor's finest single-handed? You don't seem the Sergeant York type to me. When I need your opinion,
what about Sergeant
I'll
New
ask
York?
For it.
What do you think of that guy?
They talk about officers.
Now
like
you're just
you
making shit
pull.
Up because you don't know
they call
any
it
better.
The Custer syndrome. Guys who go Sergeant around
New York
dreaming of fame
badass.
And glory and getting
really?
Off and killed.
What war did he fight in?
Our duty is to lead, Kelso, and their duty is
the,
to die for
the
your
one
wonderful
after World
future.
War II. The one in South, East, Northern, Southern Pacific Rim. Yeah, 1960.
Cole Phelps and Jack
Kelso.
With some people, it's as simple as chemistry.
Year 19,654, huh? Which side of that war was he in?
Phelps.
Well, the
guy.
American side, of course. Wild otherwise, his name would have been New York.
And Kelso. A quiet man who could never walk away from
really?
The fight.
Well, somebody didn't see Alienation.
Well, it's a shame you don't like
fuck
about
you.
Cole. Ralph. Friends who want to stay friends don't discuss religion or politics.
Farm or whatever that band
in my case,
was.
You can add the war to that.
The smooth criminal cover.
I know that bomb.
No. When Alien Nation.
Hey,
a
look,
move.
That guy's from the 70s.
Get after
that guy's
him,
from
Phelps.
The 70s.
I'll head
He's
him off in the car.
To be here. Go catch him.
Wendell Bauer.
You do not have authority to make time cop arrests. You are a normal shit cop.
Why you? Watch it.
You leave that shit to Jean-Claude Van Damme. He is a model officer.
Really, Jean-Claude Van Damme. You know, that's the same guy who drove a tank to a suspected cockfighter's
right
house on TV. Do you see that?
I fucking approved that mission. What are you talking about? Did I see that on TV? You idiot.
Wait, no, not Jean-Claude Van Damme. I'm thinking about the other guy. He's fat now, but he still has a ponytail.
Give it up, Wendell.
What's his name?
Steven Seagal.
Right.
Yeah, I transferred him to Arizona because he was a shit.
Right, I thought he lived in, like, New Orleans or something.
I don't know where the fuck happened to him after I shipped him out to Arizona.
Well, he kept making shitty straight-to-DVD stuff, so thanks a lot for that.
I've done my time.
You know, I really think you're going to go down in history
it's
for,
over,
like...
Bowers. You assholes already screwed me
you know,
once.
This guy's fat and old, but he runs around like a character from Assassin's Creed. What's up with that?
That just displays what poor shape you yourself are in, Nickmeister.
Well, my mind isn't in bad shape, because I'm not going to run around the corner and get clotheslined. I'm going to walk around nice and quiet. There you go. If you sprint around corners like that, they will knock you down.
Looks like we've got
and
the
I don't know if it really matters,
ourselves.
But I just don't like seeing Cole getting knocked down. Die, you bastard, die! Haha, finish him off!
Yeah, I really doubt you have killing hands.
You doing, Wendell?
It ended before I could do the fatality. I wanted to do the one where Cole
for an asshole
reaches
like
in
you.
His stomach and pulls
you can
out
make it
his,
up to him in 10
his
years
testicles.
Is that where you think testicles reside in a person's stomach?
Iron Hotel by tomorrow night.
Well, they,
no wonder you're a virgin as well as a shit.
Run track in high school?
They're usually there once you knee them in the crotch very hard. You know, they kind of go flying up through the large intestine into
part of the tradition of the Marine Corps, and being an officer in the Marine Corps
is the
ability
to make tough decisions.
The right decision is not always the popular one. The right decision will get the men you care about killed.
Look how small his chin is.
These ratings,
he doesn't even know how to point, let alone instruct people.
Truthfully, directly affect your chances of successfully becoming a Marine officer.
What are you trying to point at? I don't understand, sir.
Of course you don't understand. You're a shithead.
That's
you,
what happens.
You couldn't start a fire Merrill, if 10, you had two Franklin, brain cells to rub together.
Weiss, 8. Donahoe, 6.
We'll see about
Kowalski,
that.
6. Hudson, 5.
I'm try that right
Kelso,
now.
You don't even know how to count. These numbers are in all random
Donahoe,
order. You're repeating
8,
yourself.
Franklin, 7.
You're skipping
Merrill,
huge
6,
ones.
Kowalski, 6. Weiss,
I can count
5,
just fine.
Hudson,
look, there's
5,
exactly
Kelso,
17 hairs in Cole
Canada,
Phelps'
Kelso,
head right now. This guy's a bad
student. I'm
sorry,
student, Captain, but I joined the Marine Corps to fight the enemy, not
because
get involved
I guess
in
he wants to kill more
chicken
people.
Kelso, in my office
in
now!
Or something. Oh, boy. Buyer beware. Alright, so here's our first real mission. The way the
for
game is
cop,
gonna more or less play out from now
gives
on.
Gives you that leg up, gets you recognized as the shining new star on the squad. The case that you
here's
solve ensures
narration,
that you have the gumption, the gung-ho, the get-up-and-go to make you stand out from your average rank-and-file patrolman. This could be the
this
one,
could be the one.
And if you don't solve this fucking murder that happened right in front of your eyes,
LAPD,
then I'm busting
body,
you down
please,
to janitor.
Has anyone called an ambulance?
Awesome. I
we've
hear those guys have a great
police,
union.
But I'm afraid he's dead.
It's the 1940s, after all.
It's 1947. They don't got no union.
Okay, stand further back
I'm
and
sure
move
they
along.
Do.
It's your choice, but make it quick, people.
They,
hey, Cole.
You
got
a union,
quick.
I think.
My beat crosses
not in fucking 1947.
Okay. Your first reporting, then. We'll get a
you
perimeter
know,
going and move the crowd on. You better see what you can
the
find
unions
out before
down
the homicide
on,
kicks
center
show up. I'll be
main
with you in a moment.
Boulevard 632.
Everybody stay
all right, let's
back,
look
let
at this guy here.
Job.
He's got some pasta sauce in his face. I guess he's a messy eater.
I've seen everything.
You're the worse cop than you are cook. That's obviously raspberry jam.
Well, either way, he needs a napkin. Maybe he was just eating a sandwich. Let's take a look at his hand here. Oh, that's a lovely hand. Hey, it's his lifeline here says he's going to have a long life. Oh, wait.
See, you still failed at observation. There are obviously two raspberry jam sandwiches in his coat.
Yeah, what's up with that? I mean, who keeps a sandwich in their jacket? It's insane.
People with jacket
we're
pockets, you idiot.
We're obviously dealing with a criminal mastermind here. Okay, so notice that name Galetta? Well, it's got a different pronunciation, as we'll soon see. I want you guys at home to pay really close attention and figure it out for yourself.
Yeah, like anybody's going to take orders from you.
Well, it's really more of a suggestion.
See Galetta.
But if you don't subscribe to my channel and watch my videos, I might come to find you. I don't know.
You won't even face me, and you call me a friend. What makes you think you have the balls to confront a complete stranger?
Alright, so you might miss this shit over here, these shells on the ground. It's basically like some old-school point-and-click adventure shit, where if you miss one tiny pixel, you lose. It's bullshit.
Yeah, it's a good thing
especially
that
the
they fucking
mission,
glow at you, and you get an audible clue when you're near one.
It's not obvious enough. There should be like a big sign and a guy going, "Hey, there's something on the ground over here. Maybe a police officer should look."
FN Browning.
Oh, say,
so
where's this gun from?
It's an FN Browning, so it was made by Fabrique Nationale in Belgium.
Are you sure it wasn't made in Brazil? Yes. That's what you're gonna say.
No, I said Belgium.
This guy in the crowd thinks he saw something,
and you never under the impression that was somewhere else, right?
Are you trying to call me out for something,
sir,
you chicken shit asshole?
Exactly did you see?
I heard the shots.
Ooh,
I thought
I
it was
heard
a car backfiring. I saw a girl
okay,
run into the
this
store.
Is a very helpful young man here in his orange shirt. Did they wear orange shirts back in the 1940s?
What, do you think they invented the color orange in 1992?
Well, no, but I mean,
lying, don't
well, yeah, actually.
Verbally, of course.
Okay, so this guy's giving us our options here.
Love that shit.
This game's pretty heavy-handed sometimes.
See what you can coax out of it.
Basically, it caused a lot of confusion with how people play the game, which is why, I don't know, some people don't like it. I think it's actually kind of obvious once you understand what's going on. So
yeah, if it's obvious to you, I'm sure nobody else had any problems with it.
He was my boss.
Oh, you seem really upset. I can tell by your face.
Mr. Gage's first name.
Everett.
And you are?
Galleta.
That's an interesting name. Galleta.
Galleta.
Are you trying to make fun of people south of the border? You got a problem with Hispanics?
How do you know she's from south of the border? She might have even gotten born here. Okay, so, Clovis. That's kind of a weird name. Yeah, see, she's probably born here if her name's Clovis.
You think you can tell me exactly what happened, miss?
I look around the shops at lunch. I was in a store when Mr. Gage, my boss, bursts in yelling that
Well, were you late, lady?
And?
Huh?
We came back.
I don't like people who are
late. I was angry. I walked in front. I heard shots. I turned and saw Mr. Gage fall.
I can tell by the movement in your facial muscles that you are upset. Okay, so the game's going to tell us right off the bat that she's lying, as you can see up here in the left-hand corner. So we're going to accuse her of lying. Also, you can tell by her face, because it looks like she's trying to find a fly that's in the room. What's up with that, anyway? Flies just seem to disappear and reappear. I don't understand.
Yeah, I don't want to hear all this bullshit cover for your misogyny. You're accusing her because you think she's a woman.
You're lying, Miss Galleta. You know what happened.
When you have no evidence to back up that claim that she's a woman. I mean, come on, Clovis. You're going to tell me that's a gendered name?
How can you prove
those bumps in your chest aren't breasts? Those are just fakes. You're a man. So for some reason,
there are bumps in her chest are the same size as the ones in yours. I wouldn't go talking shit.
Yeah, I've been pumping iron. So this clue doesn't make any sense. She's lying about what happened at the murder. And the evidence is that she had layaway for
earrings. Will I?
You could lose.
Yeah, because she claimed she was window shopping, you idiot.
Mr. Kalu.
She could have still been window shopping. Maybe she just really likes jewelry.
He runs the jewelry store. He shows.
Besides, it's obscure. I mean, the guy outside the store tells us straight up that she was there and that she saw it. So
you were right down. You were a block away. You should have seen it. You could have seen it if you weren't such a blind fucking moron.
I was around the corner, sir.
Yeah, I don't believe that for a second.
Get back to work.
Then what happened?
Alright, so we got a new person of interest here, an Edgar Kalu in a jewelry store.
Mr. Gage clutches.
I wonder what
kind
of name Kalu is, anyway.
I hear another bang.
And I wonder what kind of person would own a jewelry store.
Oh, let me guess. You got a problem with the Jews now.
It's very painful.
Hey. Don't go accusing people.
First it's Hispanics, then it's women, now it's Jews. You're just a racist, misogynist piece of shit, aren't you?
Between 5th and 6th.
We don't know for sure that he's a Jew, so let's not.
Of course I did.
You know, jump to conclusions before we start hating his fucking guts.
What do you mean, weak pale face? You're the racist here.
Pulling the trigger.
I've been getting a tan. Working outside lately.
And walked away.
All right, so doubt is basically the same thing as lie, except you don't have any evidence for it. That was something that threw a lot of people for a loop and caused them to pull their hair out and turn off the game and give it bad reviews.
Yeah, I think you're just talking about yourself again.
Yeah. It doesn't really make any sense. I mean,
is that what you want?
Later on, people
tell me why Mr. Kalu shot Mr. Gage.
Accuse people of doubt like
Mr.
all the
Gage
time.
Mr. Gage hates Jews. A lot of people do. It's not my fault if he has nice things.
Jews and their nice things.
You see,
people learn.
Racist, right there.
What?
You.
They have nice things. They have nice things.
Those Jews.
Yeah, they got nice things.
Those people.
They were so
those
loud.
Those people, yeah, they you know, they hoard it all in a,
yeah,
in a chest, I think.
All I'm hearing is intolerance, racism, misogyny, bullshit, incompetence.
So, this one's truth, even though she looks like she's lying.
I need you to concentrate, Miss Galetta. Even minor details can become important later on.
Like the date of your operation.
Well, there was one bang. And then another. and then three very quickly close together.
You could have known that if you just counted the fucking shell casings you found. Thank right, you have problems with numbers.
We'll need you to make a formal
statement
about it.
It's not like I can't get around
it. Does that mean I can still collect my...
some clever detective work.
My...
So, clever?
Never mind.
All you did was yell at the woman, accuse her of being a man, and tell her to make a sandwich.
Well, you know, you gotta let them know where you stand.
We have the murder weapon.
And the murder.
And do you realize that you stand at the bottom of the totem pole?
A jewelry store called
and I'm ready to shove you into the ground.
Thinking what I'm thinking.
Well, I am a pale face. Anyway, we don't have to talk to Clovis over there. We could go to the gun store and find out who owns the gun.
You know the way. You can drive.
But because we talked to the lady, we don't even have to go to the gun store, so fuck it. He's not really as interesting as the last gun store owner was. There, and you see, I'm letting the partner drive this time, alright? So, no more complaints.
Yeah, only because I yanked your license after the last case.
What, you didn't like my driving? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
I'm trying to tell you that you do not belong in control of anything. I'm surprised I let you keep your belt.
Well, that's why I don't control my mind anymore.
Can I interest you in a new watch?
Officer Cole Phelps. Are you Edgar Kalu?
Mr. Kalu
is
out back.
Oh, that's good. I was afraid you were,
I'll buzz him for you.
Oh, never mind. And, I knew it. Sneaky motherfucker. They're all like that. I don't understand why.
Maybe because racists like you come after them constantly.
What? I'm not racist.
Kalu,
are you saying that Jew is not an ethnicity?
Every man for himself.
I was referring to people who wear ties like that.
Yeah, right. Who hoard things because they're Jews.
Right.
Like the wall.
Die! Oh, hey, you didn't shoot him.
Stop, or I will shoot.
That's why it's called a warning shot. Why you had to aim at him that long just to fire into the air, I don't know. I guess you really had to stop yourself from committing first-degree murder.
Exactly. I had to concentrate really hard not to let myself just end him.
The case that makes you, and the case that breaks you. The one you never solve. The one that keeps you awake at night. The case that gnaws at your guts
like
and ruins your marriage.
Bottle of Red Bull
the case
right
that keeps you
popping
up a bar as you relive the what ifs, the might have beens, the half
kicks you in the nuts and spits in your face and calls you Sally.
The case that,
that
other cops
case.
Murmur about whenever you walk past.
Yeah.
See, this is how you know I'm not a racist. I hired this fine
God's
gentleman.
God's mill may grind slowly, but it grinds finely, son. I hear it's
you
who not done
malefactor.
Does he
ever take you to his house and serves you?
Then tell me, Boyle. I hear you're quite the climber. A man of initiative.
Whatever they eat.
How would you like a chance at smiting this man with the sword of justice?
Next you're calling him a Mick, huh?
To conduct the interview, sir?
He's got a similar hairline to mine.
You've
so
only been with us a short
bad.
Time and you've assembled yourself a stellar arrest record.
This
not
man has passion about his job. You are practically
from.
A robot. You could not give... I hear you yawning. That is... Ugh! I am this close to putting my foot straight up your ass.
Do you think you might be ready for that?
Yes, sir.
He just definitely has a thing for justice.
Man.
He's always talking about it.
You need many things for a conviction, young Phelps. A motive, opportunity, hard evidence,
God.
And best of all,
trying to tell
I
me
confession.
How to do my fucking job. This guy just sits at
a
desk
in the
all
former,
day.
You can always use a modicum of violence
we
to a
shut up.
Ladder. How are you feeling now?
Oh, did he ask a question?
Fine,
oh,
sir.
Yeah, I'll just say okay.
Very good.
Oh, yes, sir.
The evidence
yes, sir.
Is overwhelming. May the cat eat him and the cat be
what?
Eaten by the devil. Bring
cat
your confession, young fellows.
Devils? What are you talking
this
about?
No.
Is your chance.
He's a rat.
Don't fail me.
So a cat would eat him, and then a devil would eat the cat, because as we all know, cats are evil.
I wasn't listening.
Yeah, that's
as
why you're
Roger,
such a shit
see
cop.
My lawyer.
A lawyer can't help you, Mr. Kalu.
Oh.
Shot a man
if you
dead
shoot him, you don't have
blood,
to listen.
You're going to have
except
to pay
to their
for that.
Screams. Mwahaha. All right,
yeah, the
so
screams of you getting raped in prison for going down for murder.
You followed Everett Gage.
This is the first interview where they don't hold their hands.
You put
but
five
it's still pretty easy.
In Gage's back.
Gage was a bastard. Whatever he got
nice
what was tie,
you jerk.
But it had nothing to do with me.
All right, so this guy's obviously a liar.
Oh, because he's Jewish?
Well, besides that, his eyes are looking around. In the L.A. Noir world, and I forgot what the guy even said because I wasn't listening when
you
I was.
You weren't even game, listening so I... to the guy you're interrogating. Way to go.
So I had to fucking check. I had to check the dialogue before I made a decision. And here I am looking at all the clues. Well, we've got the gun, but I didn't go to the gun store, so I can't use the gun. But I can use the suspect positively identified by the clerk.
You shot Gage, and we know why. We can put you at the scene.
You can't prove
You're
anything.
You're a fucking liar.
At least he's more competent than you.
This lady who doesn't even know how to pronounce her own name, like an American, pointed you out.
You're counting on the girl? You think her testimony's gonna stand up in court?
You're going to the gas chamber,
yeah.
Edgar.
That Jew-hating fuck couldn't leave me alone.
It's a new skin treatment.
I had a sale. That girl was ready to buy.
Let's change the subject. You fasting for Yom Kippur, Mr. Cullen?
Yeah, let's change the subject, you going motherfucker. How about baseball?
You're not denying you're a Jew, Mr. Kalu.
This is America. It's not Germany.
Oh,
it's
yeah?
It's not a crime.
Some people don't like Jews, Mr. Kalu.
Yeah, and I guess you're one of them.
Gage hated Jews, didn't he, Mr. Kalu?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I doubt you that you're not a Jew,
left-wing
buddy.
Parasite. You expect me to sit here and
How can you say
dream?
That being from Boston?
You call me that? You sit there and you call me those
What's
names, you goddamn goy butt snatcher. You and that stump Gage.
You're a liberal left-wing parasite, is what I'm getting at.
He's in the Chamber of Commerce.
Oh, yeah,
he's
that's
in with
true.
All those momsers. He blocked every proposal I ever put forward. Kike this and kike that. He's been trying to ruin my business for
Boston.
Years.
Edgar Kalu. I'm charging you
yes,
first
and I ranked up. Nice.
I don't know how you managed to elicit a confession of a guy just by calling him a racist
your
when
sake,
you're the racist.
Commute to murder in the second degree.
But you got a result, and I can't argue with results. I'll let you be a real cop again.
Some fucking recognition for once.
I'll take just away that done, little paper Thopes. Cutout I gave you and give you back your badge.
Isn't it
Thank
that?
You.
Yes, sir.
But I don't get to keep the paper cut
then
out.
Let me have a word with the chief of police, young folks.
I was thinking about
that's going to be
you know?
A bonus at the end of the year if you keep calling it out in cases.
I applaud a man with
if, and that is
okay.
I'm going to fucking frame it in my office so that every time you come in, oh wait, you don't. Never mind.
Well, you know,
that's why you're not getting
it
back. That's why you're a shit cop, and that's why you're not getting any bonus.
I'm sorry to hear that. But as much fun as it's been with you all and my friend circlmastr here, we've reached the end of this little jaunt into LA, Hollywood. And I'll see you guys next time with our next video. Goodbye. See you later.
Back to work.